Hey everybody, this is 22 Tiger Dude.
Hello.
And we are here to review 22 Jump Street, which is a sequel to 21 Jump Street. Imagine there were two 22 Jump Street.
That would be hilarious.
That would. It's from Phil Lord and Christopher Miller. With 22 Jump Street, the plot is that it's really the same as the first. The only difference is that Jonah Hill and Channing Tatum, they go to college. They have to find out who this drug dealer is. And that's really it for a plot, huh?
Kind of, and except for all the crazy parties.
There were crazy parties in the first one, too.
Yeah, but that was in high school, but college is a lot more.
And yeah, it's pretty much the same thing, except more wilder. That's the best way to describe it. So, going into 22 Jump Street, as much as I love 21 Jump Street, it's one of my favorite films of 2012, actually. It just makes me laugh so hard. I wasn't too interested in 22 Jump Street. The trailers, just watching it, made me go, yeah, this looks like the same old thing. And I just wasn't really too interested in seeing the film. How did you feel about 22 Jump Street going into it?
I thought it was funny, but there's stuff that it was kind of, like, you know, alright.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Coming out of 22 Jump Street, after all the positive reviews I've heard about it and how it's better than the original, everyone is pretty much loving 22 Jump Street. I love the original, and now that I've seen the sequel, I'm sorry, you guys. I just didn't like it. The sequel was what I expected. Just an okay, same old movie.
For me, it's like they're both equally, because they're same partners, like they were, they have the same humor.
Like, you know, they still have that chemistry going on.
Yeah.
I'll start off with positives I had with the film. I still do think Jonah Hill and Channing Tatum are a great duo. You know, they work well with each other.
Yeah.
That's what makes the sequel at least watchable for me. The fact that I know these actors have a lot of fun. Same could go to Ice Cube and all the other actors that are in here. Yeah, they did a really good job in the film. I thought Ice Cube did a good job here as well. There was one scene where he pretty much has an angry meltdown at a restaurant without getting too much into detail. He was pissed, and it was actually one of the funnier moments of the film, in my opinion. I also did like the opening scene of 22 Jump Street. As soon as the movie opened, it actually gave me what I loved about 21 Jump Street. It gave me that feeling. So when the movie opens, it's just all like, okay, so far I'm actually liking this. And it's just all like, after that first 5 minutes, I just don't really like the movie. And I am seeing that serranoreyesj. There are mildly funny moments, and I'll admit it has some clever moments to it. Like, it pokes fun at the fact that it is a sequel. The movie is aware that it's the same old thing.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I'll give that movie respect. It's not like Hangover Part 2, where while that movie I also thought was okay, it was just the same old thing. And this movie's a rehash, but it's at least aware that it's a rehash. I thought the movie looked good. The action sequences, just like in the original, I thought they were very well filmed. They were very exciting. And just how they poke fun. You know, they're making fun of what happens in action films and stuff. So, yeah. I'll give the movie props. I enjoyed the party scenes, too. The party scenes were very well filmed, and I enjoyed the music behind there. As for my negatives, though, this movie, for the most part, is, like, really boring to me. A lot of the humor doesn't really hit for me.
It's pretty good because, you know, it shows like most of the stuff what best friends would have, like, no matter where they are. They had that best friend connection, like, you know, they would have with or without each other.
Yeah.
It shows what would happen if they're, I guess, best buddies.
I know a lot of humor hit for you because you were laughing more than I was. There was this girl, she's the blonde one. She makes jokes at the fact that Jonah Hill is old. It's just so like, I didn't see any point of that character. I just didn't like that character, and she got on my nerves just a little bit. And there was this scene involving her and Jonah Hill, like, punching each other, like, is that the best you got, motherfucker? Punch me harder! And they're having, like, this punch thing. It's like, what the fuck am I watching? I'll admit, it was kind of funny. I kind of laughed at that. But after a while, it does drag on for me. And the storyline to itself, I just didn't think it was as well written. Like, I try to force down some of the things in the humor or try to drag on a little bit of some of the conversations. You know what I mean?
Okay. I see, but it's like, they're just showing like how that would be if something the situation, like, in the force. Like, you know, like, on the police who are on duty, they have been best friends for so long. That's probably why it's been a little bit forced on like that.
And I also did feel like it wasn't very paced that well. The pacing kind of felt a little bit choppy to me. Like I said, it felt boring for most of the movie, which is ironic because it's a comedy. I'm supposed to laugh throughout the film, but instead I'm watching this going, that wasn't that funny. I just didn't really find it that funny. It really just did not make me laugh. I was hoping to be surprised by this film because I love this film so much. It makes me laugh my ass off, but this film just makes me go, oh, lame. Oh, I did like that girl that Jonah Hill was with. I thought she was a nice little touch to the film, yeah. You know? And I bought into their chemistry. I actually did think they had good chemistry with each other. I didn't hate it, but I just thought it could have been a lot better.
I thought it was enjoyable, like, for people who are, I guess, cops.
Yeah.
It's like a cop humor thing.
True. Any flaws you have with the film?
So far, except the parts with those special toys for those ladies.
Yeah.
I think that should have been different.
Like, what do you mean?
Like, they should have been, like, you know, like, should not shown it. You know what the toys I'm talking about in the movie?
The dildos?
Yes. I think it was good. It's just, like, that part was a little bit flawed.
Oh, yeah, I get you, man. Overall, 22 Jump Street was unfortunately not a surprise to me. It was exactly what I expected, just being okay. The cast does a good job. I still enjoy Jonah Hill and Channing Tatum's chemistry. Ice Cube was very funny at times. Also, be sure to stick around for the end credits, which I know a lot of people are saying is like the most hilarious end credits scene ever. But even to me, even the end credits wasn't even worth waiting for. I didn't even really laugh at that, to be honest.
A tiny bit, but trust me, it's like, you know, it was too much.
It's just not, like, the funniest one to you.
Nah. Like, in the middle, like, the part when they asked the dude for something, asking questions, that was funny, but
yeah,
that last part, it's like a so-so.
Oh, yeah, and speaking of that, by far the scene with Rob Riggle and Dave Franco, to me, that wasn't a funny scene. That was disgusting. It was disturbing, and yeah, I just didn't like it. Just that whole scene right there, it just felt really forced to me. And it's just like, oh my gosh.
Showing you how the prison life looks like.
Yeah, but that scene, I just thought was a little too much. I just didn't like that scene.
Well, they're showing all the kids, their kids. They're showing, like, all the kids how it looks like.
Yeah.
They're going to do something stupid.
Yeah.
Like, robbing a bank or something. That's what they're going to end up with.
And I also did enjoy a few cameo appearances that were in here. I thought the cameos were pretty good.
Yeah.
So any final words you have to say about 22 Jump Street?
It's good, except for the thing with the little toys, with the women toys. That's pretty much all.
So he equally enjoys the first. I think the first is way better. I love the original. Makes me laugh my ass off. Unfortunately, the sequel...
Your ass is laughing? I can't hear it.
Sequel, unfortunately, it just didn't do it for me. I don't hate it. It's not the worst. Definitely not, but it wasn't really all that entertaining in terms of comedy. I've seen better comedies. Hell, A Million Ways to Die in the West wasn't that good of a comedy, and I was more entertained by that film than 22 Jump Street right here. I'm gonna give 22 Jump Street 2 out of 4 stars. It's okay, but yeah, it's a very lame sequel in my opinion.
4.5.
Well, thanks for reviewing 22 Jump Street with me, serranoreyesj.
No problem.
And let's do the annual high five.
What is it?
Which is boom.
Just kidding.
High five, man.
Just kidding.
Holy shit, we need to go to the emergency room.
Okay, give me duct tape. That's all we need. Just kidding.
22 Tiger Dude. Don't forget, the owl always have Tiger Power!